Welcome to all of you here present on such a joyous occasion. Reverend Fathers who came from all over, family who came from all over on quite some trips, and friends who came from all over to surround Jamie and Brigid with affection and prayer on this, their wedding day.
Yeah, so I remember the first time I met Brigid. We were at a president's home as our first date, and so we had never met before.
But we went there on December 7th. We did a tour of the property, and I'm a huge history buff, so it was fun just retracing one of our founding father's steps with him. And we were able to talk about our own lives and both having served in the Army and just a lot of the overlap that we had had with West Point and friends and things like that. So it was really nice just to be able to have kind of a low-key first date like that.
You know, I got a little bit nervous meeting for the first time. We'd been talking the last few days on the phone, and it was exciting. She was beautiful and just really friendly.
You're beautiful.
So we met through this app called Catholic Match, and my search algorithm was quite wide. I didn't really have a limited geography, just hoping to meet somebody, you know, beautiful but good.
I had a pretty tight radius set, really only wanted within 10 miles of where I lived, but Jamie, I guess, was a little bit more willing to travel farther to find love.
She was about ready to get rid of the app. I had gone on one or two dates and it was not working well for me either. So I remember praying, and within a few days of that, she popped up within my search, and I said, you know, this profile looks beautiful. I'm gonna click on this. And I'm looking through and I felt intimidated. I really didn't feel like I had a chance with Brigid.
When I saw his face, he just had an amazing smile, and I clicked on his profile to read a little bit more about him and realized that he'd been in the Army too, had gone to West Point, had also lived over in Italy and explored Europe, and immediately I just felt, you know, there was a lot of commonality, so that would at least be a good starting point.
And so she reached out to me, and thankfully, you know, she said, hey, we have these things in common, and we were talking maybe within the next day on the phone, and we met less than a week later in person. So with both having a bit of a military background, she describes it as she was tactically surprised but not strategically surprised. So we had definitely talked for more than a year about getting engaged.
Had agreed we wanted to get married, and we looked at a couple rings online, and I sort of showed him styles and everything else that I liked, and he had a conversation with my dad to get his blessing and everything.
I already wanted to ask her, of course, but like I had not chosen a day. And I had a strong feeling while I was praying during the Mass that I'm supposed to ask today, like this is the day.
We get back to the townhouse, and I'd been packing boxes all day up to that point. So I said, well, come and see, you know, all the progress I made on packing boxes. And so I took him to one room down in the basement.
So I go down to where she had stacked up all these boxes in the basement, basically. And so as she kind of turned around to show something else.
He got down on one knee and said, well, I've got one more little box for you here. And then that's when he proposed.
When she turned back, she was, you know, not surprised, like, because we knew we wanted to get married, but she was not expecting it then, for sure. I definitely got her by surprise.
We had our first toast of champagne with West Point Class of 2011 wine glasses.
And it was pretty awesome.
Here's to you, Brigid.
Seeing people come together, not just for us, but seeing people come together and enjoy time together is something that I think has been lacking. And so obviously, like, I'm excited to get married, but I'm excited for a community to be there supporting us and to share that moment with Brigid, knowing she's loved, knowing that I'm loved, and that we're loved together as a couple.
Oh,
I think it'll be when the door opens in the church from the vestibule, and I'll be able to see Jamie at the other end of the aisle standing up on the altar and everyone else who's in the pews. We've had a lot of very generous friends and family make long trips to come here and celebrate with us, so it's just very meaningful that we're able to do that.
James, do you take Brigid here present for your lawful wife according to the rite of our Holy Mother Church?
I do.
Brigid, do you take James here present for your lawful husband according to the rite of our Holy Mother Church?
I do.
I, James,
take you, Brigid, for my lawful wife.
For my lawful wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward,
for better, for worse,
for richer, for poor, in sickness and in health, until death do us part.
I, Brigid,
take you, James, for my lawful husband, to have and to hold,
from this day forward,
for better, for worse, for richer, for poor,
in sickness and in health,
until death do us part.
Take this ring
as a pledge of my love and fidelity.
As a pledge of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Ghost.
And of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Amen.
Take this ring
as a pledge of my love and fidelity.
As a pledge of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
Holy Ghost.
And of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
May he take you up into his eternal dominions in heaven through our Lord Jesus Christ, his Son, who lives and reigns with him in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
In the weakest of times, you are everything. You're my beautiful King.
Brigid truly has a heart of gold. Even though she puts in long days and hours at work, she never fails to call, send a card, or plan a trip just to say congratulations, happy birthday, or wish somebody congrats on an achievement, offer encouragement during a challenging time, or simply just because. Even when she's living across the country or on the other side of the world. Brigid, your love for your parents, your brother, your nephews, and me is unconditional. We thank God for the blessing of you in our lives each and every day. We look forward to watching Jamie's and your love for each other grow as you embark on the greatest adventure of your life, marriage.
As the best man in the room, which I clearly am, right? It's in the title. As the best man in the room, at this point, Brigid, I would love to relinquish that title to the man sitting next to you. Everyone, I'd like you to raise your glasses to the best man, Jamie, and Brigid, his wife.
Your lives now and your souls are bound forever. So we're going to raise our glass and ask God to continue to bless you, the fruits of your marriage. Cheers.